Great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Oklahoma Sooners and the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
Check out these playmakers. The kids at the point should give us a show tonight.
Dick, we've got two great teams, two ranked teams battling out here tonight. Anytime you got a matchup of this caliber, you can expect a great game of basketball. And the referee is ready to toss it up. The Cowboys get possession with some nice hustle. Moving it around the perimeter. With a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. And boy, they just jump out of the gate with a score early.
They're sending the message, we're focused, baby.
And now getting set up in three around two.
Hey, look for the three perimeter players to go inside and then space. The four should look for each other. If one is front, then the other should flash and look to go high-low.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Woodard handles the pass. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
Andre did a great job creating a good angle too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
Cross court. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
High post screen.
Looking for a good shot. Turnover by the senior. Woodard receives the ball. Cross court. Launches the three. Knocked it down. Working around the perimeter. He tries the three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's getting it done out there, Brad. They'd be in trouble without him.
They work the perimeter from way outside. Can't connect. They'll bring it blocked. Nice job defensively. Now looking to attack. He hammers it home. That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. In the lane. Missed it. Oh, yes. In the post. With a jumper. The missed shot. Number 13 takes the feed. Goes up with a shot. Nails the jumper. Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries a three. Missed the jumper. The point guard with the ball.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Goes up for two. He can't get the bucket to fall. attempts the jump shot. Jumper won't go. Pushes it up. He puts up the tray. Off the mark. For two. You betcha. Wow, partner, this crowd is something else when it gets going.
These fans love it, baby. They're more than a sixth man. This crowd is like a whole other team in the stands. This is what college basketball is all about.
On the left side. Tries one from three-point land. Knocks it down. Cross court.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Off the mark.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket. Gets it to fall.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He tries the jumper and come up short. The crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Shoots from outside.
The jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
He bombs from outside. He can't get the hoop to fall. Number 13 receives the pass. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He's taking too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
Blocked. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Puts up the jumper. Can't connect. Cross court. Around 8 minutes remaining. The shooting guard with the ball. Man, Dick, they are making scoring here look impossible.
Well, you know, they're not concentrating, Brad. They've got to lock down on the rim and shoot the ball with confidence.
And now the fadeaway jumper. My goodness, Dick, have you ever seen such poor shooting before?
They can't buy one, Brad. This is embarrassing.
On the dribble, gives it up, tries for two. That's good. Working it around the perimeter. Goes up. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Goes up with it. Gets the J to fall. Looking for a screen on top and got it. The point guard takes the feed. Trying to feed the low block. Change of possession. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
It seems like he's everywhere at once. He's been making good decisions and been strong with the ball. The coach has got to be happy with his performance so far.
Got him trapped. And it's knocked loose.
And the fans love it, man. They love it. Our house, baby. Our house.
Spangler keeps it in. Here we go on the break. We're at the 6-minute mark. There's a slam.
Up and inside.
Three. The missed shot. Smart receives the pass. Puts up the tray. Nails a sweet jumper. The fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Missed it. Brown handles the pass. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. He puts up the J. They got it. And a timeout's called. We got a break in the action. Stay tuned for more NCAA basketball coverage. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout.
Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Off the mark with that shot. Nice shot. On the right side.
Clock shot usually creates momentum and opportunities.
We'll stay right here. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Into their zone motion now. They've got a player spotting up on the three. He's money with the shot. We're at the 4-minute mark. Trying to pack it inside for two. No good. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Cross court. From the corner, jumper won't go. They got the offensive rebound and the stick back. Top of the circle. Nope. We're at the 3-minute mark. On the outside. From the top of the circle. Scores it. Unloads a three. Missed the jumper. Woodard handles the pass.
trying to go inside.
He shoots from the deep corner. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
On the outside. He goes up with it. Off the mark. About 2 minutes remaining. Scorches the net with a J. Gave it up. Outside jumper. Knocks it down. Dribble, gives it up. Ten to shoot now. Can't connect. Sinks it. 1 minute left to go. He shoots the jumper. Missed it. On the left side. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turan fadeaway. Had a momentary look from 3-point land. Bust the jumper. The perimeter. Blocks it. He comes up empty. At halftime, the Cowboys lead by 6. Oklahoma State did quite a performance in the first half shooting that 3-ball.
They certainly found a stroke out there, fishing for the trifecta, man, and they struck gold.
And here's a look at what each team here today will be focusing on when we get things underway.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Like a full-court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale. Looking for a good shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Boy, assist-to-turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
They're working around the perimeter. And the jam. Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
They'll work it around the arc. For the bucket. Makes it. And now getting set up here to 4-round-1.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
They go into the low block. Goes up for 2. Buried it. Cross court. Pulls up with a jumper. the missed shot. There's the pick. Inside. Gets the rejection. Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Nails the jumper. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Jumper won't go. Gave it up. He attempts the jump shot. Scores it. Looking for a good shot. He tries the three ball. Nails the fadeaway. Fed the low block. Tries for two. And come up short. Perimeter. Brown is spent right now emotionally, Dick.
Hey, he may need some encouragement from one of his teammates.
They work the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Off the mark. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
Off the glass and no good. Cross court. With the J. Nope. And a big rebound.
Now they've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
Puts up the J. Knocked it down. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Goes.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Jumper. Can't connect. Now they work it around the perimeter. Shot off. Woodard receives the ball. He shoots from outside. Missed it. Gave it up. The fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Missed the jumper. Woodard handles the pass. Now trying to feed the low block. There they are on the low block on the move inside, and the big guy picks up the foul.
Hey, Brad, you can't allow a guy to get the ball in that deep, and he does a great job putting it to the deck and attacking the basket.
Throws it up from downtown. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
Brown handles the feed. Had his shot rejected. Woodard handles the pass. Goes up with a shot. They got it. Brown handles the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Unloads. Gets the J to fall. 8 minutes left on the game clock.
That's one of the things I absolutely love about college basketball, Dick, the atmosphere.
Brad, it's rocking and rolling in here, baby.
Takes his jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Goes up. Off the mark. Makes the shot. Cross court. He looks for three. He missed. For two. He buries it. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Inside. For the bucket. The missed shot. Woodard handles the pass. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He takes a three. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the J. Jumper won't go. The Cowboys are going to have to transition into playing strictly a half-court style now.
Hey, with the lead, they have to really focus on defense and defensive stops. The goal now should be to run sets and keep the clock from stopping. Pressure that basketball.
Tries for two. He shows the sweet touch. The Sooners are going to have to switch some things up here, Mr. Vitale. When you consider time and score, I think it's time for them to ditch the half-court style and get some easy baskets.
It's all about quick shots now, Brad. They're going to have to get stops and then quick scores to overcome this deficit.
He shoots from downtown. Busts the fadeaway J. Gave it up. He pulls the trigger. Perfectly executed. About 5 minutes remaining. Dumps it in. Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper. Loose ball save. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Brown receives the pass.
Up and inside.
He shoots from the corner. Rims out. He hits the shot. The dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the deep corner. Knocked it down. We're at the 4 minute mark.
Look at that spacing.
lets it fly. He can't get the hoop to fall. In terms of balance,
great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
On the outside. For the bucket. With a layup. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
That's a great take, Brad. That puts pressure on the defense when you go to the hoop like that.
Down inside. For the deuce. Off the backboard. The point guard with the ball.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
3 minutes left in the game clock.
There's the trap.
Tries for two. Off the glass. Number 24 receives the ball. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
On the outside. Up with the shot. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Missed the jumper. Smart handles the pass. Gave it up.
Look at these fans. They're loving it.
It's electrifying in here.
Cross court. He takes the three. He drains the jumper. He shoots from the elbow. He makes the jumper. The shooting guard with the ball. Goes up for two. Was that beautiful or what? 1 minute left to go. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Pushes it. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Off the backboard. Lays it up. Trying to feed inside. Jumper. Rims out.
Better fall quick.
That shot makes it a one-point contest.
Hey, it's anybody's game, baby.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. As we take a look at the sophomore.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
Second Three-point shot is no good.
So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
As you guys know, free throw shooting becomes very important down the stretch. The coaching staff is aware of this, and we'll be talking about this in the timeout. It'll be up to the players to knock them down.
Well, Dick, it's always important to come out of a timeout with a game plan, I think.
You know, very important. It's a chance to get your team on the same page, talk about what's happened previously and what's about to happen in the future. I hate it when teams come out of a timeout unorganized and without a plan.
To the live action we go. The small forward receives the pass and come up short. And the clock stopped with a foul. He'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
What kind of energy are we looking at after that timeout, Dick?
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
Oklahoma State loses a close one.
It's always tough to lose to a team that you know you can beat.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.